Recording. Divide and conquer means get the answer using the shortcut. So what's 12 divided by 1/3? Everybody should be able to now do it in your head, right? Because it's taking the second fraction and flipping it to its reciprocal. Because that's the shortcut for doing all division. You want me to model it out? I can model it out, but it's going to take twice as long. No matter what, think of, model it in your head. Think of 12 pieces, and you're splitting it up into thirds. How many total pieces would you have? 12 times 3, keep, change, flip. That's the shortcut. 4 divided by 1/11. 7 divided by 1/10. All right, you know it. Okay, this is a little different. First of all, not only do you have a word problem, but you'll see they're giving you the whole, and you've got to kind of find the part, the piece in the middle. So let me read it out loud to you. Molly used 9 cups of flour to bake bread. If this was 3/4 of the total amount, if what was 3/4 of the total amount? Make a connection there, because we're going to use that. If this 9 cups was only 3/4 of the total amount of the flour she started with, what was the original amount of the flour? There's 2 ways you can model it. It'll also relate very closely to part-whole relationships, as we did when we did the ratios unit. Okay, as stated, this problem is a little different than what we did. It's actually last period. They're telling us that 3/4 of a number that we're trying to find has to equal 9. Essentially, what it is 3/4 times what number equals 9. And as you'll see, when we do something down the road here, we're going to show you that's kind of the same as taking 9 and dividing it by 3/4, or how many 3/4 are in 9. I'm going to use a fraction bar and model it a little differently, and just please stop me if you get lost. It's different than what we've been doing. How many total pieces do I have? How many are shaded? 3 out of 4. That's where those 3/4 are coming from. Okay? These 3 pieces that are shaded represent what number? Aha. What did I tell you in the word problem? It's connecting with what? The 9. Right? Let me show you where that's coming from. Put the 9 here. Molly used 9 cups of flour to bake bread. If this 9 was 3/4 of the total amount, then this 3/4 is representing 9. Good so far? Use your magic number now to figure out the value of each box. Right, 3 out of 4 are shaded. Those 3 boxes are representing 9. Find the magic number. No. 9 into 3 boxes, like we did back in tape diagrams back in the first module. Right, the magic number is 3. 3, 6, 9, right? The magic number is good for everything. Now, to figure out the whole entire amount, add up all the boxes. 12. Right? Go back and revisit what we just did, though. Look, watch. Here's the original problem. She used 9 cups. But that 9 cups wasn't the whole amount, was it? It was only 3/4 of the whole amount. So you got to kind of think, okay, 9 cups is 3/4 of the amount. Doesn't the whole amount have to be bigger? Right? It's got to be greater than 9, because 9 is not the whole amount. So the whole amount is 12. Now, what do we actually do? We took 9, and we divided it by 3/4. The answer winds up being 12. And I could model it, but we've just used a simple tape diagram to show it. can also use part to whole strategy, which I think you might like better. Part on top or bottom? Please tell me you remember this. Part to whole, remember? Ready? Watch. Tell me if this makes sense. Three is the part out of how many? That's the whole, right? Three out of four. Equals, nine is the part, find the whole. Does that work? Because look, Shannon, you have to multiply times three. Part to whole. If that kind of resonates with you, then use that as your model, if that works for you. You have to put the part and the whole in the right spot. But I think it's quicker, and I think that you have more experience using that. Well, this is the same thing. Let's just do it with pizza. Pizza. George is having a birthday party, and he has currently fed 27, I need that number, unwind it, of his guests with pizza. If this what? What is this? This 27 was only 3/8 of the total amount of guests fed. How many guests will George be feeding in total? Can I ask you this? Will the number be greater or will it be smaller? Okay. The question's asking us to find the total amount of guests, or the whole, if you will, because we could use that. Remember we did part to whole relationships? Okay, let's do tape diagram first, or fraction bar. How many boxes do I have? How many total boxes do I have? How many am I shading? Okay, shade three. And then bracket it. Those three represent, very good, very nice, 27. What's the magic number then? 9 this time, right? See why it's 9? So put 9 in every box. Add up all the boxes and tell me what you get. Or 9 times 10 times 8. I was going to go with Lauren, but what do you got, Lauren? 72. He can feed 72 guests. Here it is as a part-to-whole ratio. What was the part of the fraction? Out of? So if that helps you, the fraction that they give you is always the first ratio or the first fraction. Equals. Was 27 the part of the whole? Part, chat. No. We're trying to find the whole. How many total guests do we have to feed? They're telling you he's already fed 27 guests. Is the part? Look, go back to the question, hon. Look, it tells you. See, that 3/8 represents the 27 of his guests with pizza so far. How many guests will he feed in total? We're trying to find the total. We're trying to find the whole. Right? 27 is a part. Times 9. How many think that way shorter? Then, if you want, you can go even. We'll call this short. Shorter, and the last part's the shortest, and that's reciprocals. Let me show it to you. 27, that's the part, right? Divided by 3/8. Okay, ready? And this is 27 over 1, right? Keep the first fraction as is, which is 27 over 1. What does division get changed to? Use a dot from here on out. And what do I do with 3/8? And I'm going to show you how to make it even easier using cross-reducing down the road. But if those of you that know how to do it, you can knock out this and this and make it a 1 over a 9, but we'll get to it. But if you do 27 times 8, this is where it gets a little tricky, I guess. 27 times 8, 216, over, then you got to go 3 into 216 to figure out how many, what the whole number is. It winds up being 72. 3 into 216, because we have to change it back into a whole number. It does, but I'm going to show you how to do knockout next week. Knockout is this. Give me a number that goes into 3 and 27. You look at the corners. If this confuses you, don't do it yet. 3, what goes into 3 and 27? 8 and what? 3. 3 goes into 3 how many times? 3 goes into 27 how many times? 9 times 8? 1 times 1? Put it that way too. That's coming down the road. Okay, here's how it breaks down. Let's go back. Let's take a look. That's not what I want. Okay, so here's how we break out. Everybody's gonna do 11 and 12. Show it to me, and then once it's done, you can start your homework. Oh, that.